Hello, welcome to sutasty. This time we talk about the nutritional food source of iron. Iron is an essential trace mineral needed by our bodies. Iron is a principal constituent of blood as an essential part of hemoglobin in red blood cells. The red color of the blood comes from the substance of the iron complex, hemeiron in the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the protein containing hemeiron in the blood cells. Hemeiron exists in two proteins, hemoglobin and myoglobin. In other words, the mineral iron exists in hemoglobin and myoglobin as a hemeiron complex. About two-thirds of our body's iron is in hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the protein in our blood red cells, whereas myoglobin is the protein contained in muscles. The hemoglobin of the red blood cells in the bloodstream binds oxygen in the lungs, transports oxygen to body cells and carries carbon dioxide away from cells for elimination by the lungs. Myoglobin is a muscle protein providing oxygen to muscles for muscle contraction. The nutrition source of iron. Iron is an essential mineral needed by us and comes from our foods. Iron in the diet comes from both plant and animal food sources. The iron from plant-based foods is nonheme iron, and most iron from animal meats is heme iron. Heme iron is the iron ion in meat, poultry, and fish. Heme iron is the heme group in hemoglobin and myoglobin proteins in animal meats. The darker the color of meat, the more heme iron contained inside it. For example, beef liver, redder than roast beef, has more iron. Dark turkey meat has more heme iron than light turkey meat. Nonheme iron is the iron from plant origin foods such as leafy green vegetables and whole grain loaves of bread. Nonheme iron is a free iron ion in plants as ferrous or ferric iron phytosalts or complexes. Interestingly, egg yolks have mostly nonheme iron. Cast iron utensils are also a good source of nonheme iron when foods are cooked inside of them, especially when foods are simmered in them for a while. The iron in the cast iron utensils can be leached from the surface of the utensils into the cooked food liquid. Furthermore, when foods are cooked in cast iron utensils with acidic ingredients, such as tomato juice, orange juice or vinegar, more iron can be dissolved into the cooking liquid because acids can enhance ion leaching off the surface of the utensils. Lastly, many foods on today's supermarket shelves are enriched or fortified with nonheme iron, for example, iron-enriched flour and iron-fortified breakfast cereals. Next, we talk about iron absorption briefly. Heme iron is absorbed more readily than non-heme iron. 15% to 35% of heme iron from food gets absorbed, depending on how much iron the body has stored. Even though foods with non-heme iron often contain more iron, only 2% to 20% of non-heme iron gets absorbed. However, the bioavailability, the absorption, of iron in a mixed diet with both animal and plant-based foods, is about 18%. The presence of heme iron enhances the absorption of non-heme iron. However, non-heme iron cannot influence the absorption of heme iron. Meats such as poultry, beef, fish can increase the absorption of non-heme iron. The pairing of animal-based iron-rich foods with plant-based foods can enhance the absorption of non-heme iron contained in plant-sourced foods. For example, besides being a source of iron of its own, a small amount of group beef in a pot of chili bean soup enhances the body's absorption of non-heme iron from the beans. When you cook a fish soup, you can add tofu and simmer the soup for 15 to 30 minutes. This way, non-heme iron in tofu can be absorbed more efficiently in the presence of heme iron from fish. Sutasty made this video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.